Hi everybody and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Helen, if you don't already know me, and I am obsessed with makeup. I tried to film this video yesterday because basically I'm doing my makeup so I can film a Gymshark haul, and I have this new pigment from Mask, and it's called Vanilla Frosting and it's like silvery white, and today I've used it as a highlighter because I just wanted to use it, but yesterday I put it on my eyelids and it was so dramatic. It was ridiculous, and I'd done like a dark brown cut crease and I'd look like a drag queen, and it was just so inappropriate for a Gymshark haul. But anyway, it was hilarious. So this is my toned down makeup for my Gymshark haul, and I hope you enjoy this video, and if you do, please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe. And I will see you actually in the next clip. Hi again, it's me. So I started just by putting my hair out of my face. Oh, look at my fake tan, I'm really tanned. I am on the phone to my sister. I'm actually not talking to myself, and I'm getting ready to go out for a first birthday party where we got party bags, which was absolutely awesome. But I knew that I wanted my makeup to last all day, so I used both a primer and an illuminizer as well, which I'm just really loving doing at the moment. And then I always apply my foundation with a sponge, and this is the Clinique Beyond Perfecting foundation, which the last time I used it, I just used it almost like from the sponge onto my face. That didn't make sense. But basically I had to spread it around my face first with a brush because I find it so thick, and the coverage is absolutely amazing, but I wanted to not be quite as heavy, seeing as we were going out for the daytime. I powdered my face with MAC Studio Fix Powder Plus Foundation, and then I bronzed using a Natural Collection bronzer. I decided to do my skin first so that I wouldn't go too over the top with my eyes, because then I knew that I had to be extra careful of fallout and I wouldn't go too dark or too crazy. So in the crease I am using, it's sort of like, it looks like a brown, but it comes out quite purple, and I knew that. So that's why I used it, because I do like a pinky purple look. And then more towards the outside, and trying not to cover up that brown, I'm using a dark pink color. And if you don't have pink eyeshadows, then blushes are really, really good for that. And this is a Wet n Wild crease brush, which I ordered 3 off from, I think, Amazon. They took like 6 weeks to come, but they were only like £3 or £4 or something. So yeah, anyway, I'm loving them. I'm then going a little bit darker, and again trying not to cover too much the other two colors that I've already put down. Really simply underneath I literally just put all colors, because I didn't want to take loads and loads of time to do it. I want it to be quite a simple look. This eyeliner is insane. It is a NYX eyeliner, and it's got a really, really long name, like Slide On, Glide On, So Good It Stays On, blah, 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 blah. I don't know. It's just, it's really, really good, and it's called Bronze Shimmer or something. Oh, I don't know what it's called, but it's amazing. Go and find it, and I think it makes every eye colour look amazing, and I prefer it to putting black in the waterline. Anyway, this lip liner is from Barry M, and I just put it everywhere, and then I used a matching brown lipstick on top. For eyeliner, I'm using the one I've been using a lot recently, which is the Makeup Academy Felt Liner. And I like it because you can be quite lazy and almost lean it against your eyelashes to get a really good straight line, like use the side of the felt. And then it's easy to use to do a small wing. When I did a big wing, it actually creased a little bit, but I just have creasy eyelids, so I'm sure it potentially isn't the eyeliner. It's potentially my point. But yeah, it has a really good sharp nib as well, so you can create a good point with it. This is the pigment, like this is what it's all about, and I was trying to be light-handed, but I'm pretty sure I put on like another 2 layers and then went down my nose and Cupid's bow and even in between my eyebrows, and that's when I had probably a little bit too much on the brush, so I was glowing. But yes, look at my nose, oh my god, love that pigment so much. Amazing on the eyes. Choose your colors wisely, potentially not dark brown with it. And then curled my eyelashes. And then the mascara I used is from my first ever Birchbox. And it's the Douce Punk Volumizer Mascara. Oh, I didn't realize I just said that like that. I loved the way that this applied. I did like one really, really good thick layer and probably didn't even need to go in with a second layer, but obviously I did. You have to. The last thing I did is do my eyebrows with a Maybelline Eyebrow Pomade Crayon. So I've done it before where I've literally just applied the crayon straight onto my eyes, but I didn't. It went weird. Anyway, with an angled brush, it's really good. Time consuming though, because the pigment doesn't come off particularly quickly, but I like the colour of it and it looks relatively natural. And because it's relatively waxy, it keeps everything in place. Here we go. Second coat of mascara because you just have to. And I 100% regret putting it on my lower lashes because it always, always falls down, but it does finish the look. And that is the finished look. Thank you so, so much for watching. I hope you really like it, and I will see you in my next video.